Welcome and thanks for watching. In this video, we will be discussing chromosomal nondisjunction and how its effects differ between meiosis 1, meiosis 2, and mitosis. Before we get started, let's first define what a chromosomal nondisjunction is. Broadly speaking, a chromosomal nondisjunction is the failure of chromosomes or chromatids to separate properly, resulting in daughter cells with abnormal numbers of chromosomes. Because anaphase is a stage in which chromosomes or chromatids separate, this is where we see nondisjunction events occur. Additionally, because anaphase is an essential step in mitosis, meiosis 1, and meiosis 2, nondisjunction events can afflict all three of these stages of cell division, with differing effects depending on where and in which process it takes place in. Let's first describe how chromosomal nondisjunction occurs in mitosis, and what effects we see as a result. During mitosis, the genetic material of a parent cell is divided equally into two new daughter cells, so that each new cell contains all the genetic information it needs to function. During anaphase of this process, two sister chromatids separate to different poles of the cell, ensuring that both resulting daughter cells get the correct number of chromosomes and are identical to the parent cell. Mitotic nondisjunction occurs when something goes wrong in this process, and sister chromatids do not separate properly. As a result, we still get the creation of two new diploid daughter cells, but one has an extra chromosome, denoted by the 2n+1 notation, and the other cell is missing a chromosome, denoted by the 2n-1 notation. As mentioned previously, chromosomal nondisjunctions can also occur in meiosis, during either anaphase 1 or anaphase 2, and we see varying effects depending on when a nondisjunction event occurs. Now, the overall goal of meiosis is for diploid cells to undergo two stages of division to ultimately produce four haploid gamete daughter cells with half as many chromosomes as the parent cell. During anaphase 1 of meiosis 1, homologous chromosome pairs separate and move towards opposite poles of the cell. Nondisjunction occurs in meiosis 1 when these homologous chromosome pairs fail to separate, resulting in one haploid daughter cell with an extra chromosome and the other with a missing chromosome at the end of meiosis 1. The effects of this nondisjunction are propagated as the cell completes meiosis, even with normal function during meiosis 2. As a result of a nondisjunction in anaphase 1, two of the four resulting gamete cells have extra copies of a chromosome, while the other two have no copies of a chromosome. As we can tell from this information, nondisjunctions that arise during meiosis 1 impact normal chromosome inheritance in all four daughter cells. Nondisjunctions can also occur in anaphase 2 of meiosis 2. Under normal cellular conditions, sister chromatids separate during this stage so that each resulting gamete has one copy of each chromosome. When nondisjunction occurs in anaphase 2, however, these sister chromatids fail to separate, resulting in daughter cells with abnormal chromosome counts. When this occurs, only the daughter cells that directly result from the nondisjunction event are affected, with one cell having extra copies from the chromosome that failed to separate, and one cell lacking any copies of that chromosome. As we can tell, nondisjunctions that arise during meiosis 2 only impact the two daughter cells derived from the cell where the error occurred, leaving the other two daughter cells unharmed. This differs from nondisjunctions that occur in meiosis 1, because we would see all four cells expressing chromosomal abnormalities. Now let's take a look at the effects of nondisjunctions that arise in meiosis. Nondisjunctions that occur during meiosis tend to have more adverse effects than mitotic nondisjunctions, and are associated with aneuploidy-related conditions, or conditions marked by the presence of chromosomal abnormalities. This is because chromosomal errors that arise during meiosis create abnormal gametes that can propagate chromosomal abnormalities to offspring. With this in mind, if a zygote is formed from a gamete that has experienced a nondisjunction event, the resulting offspring will have an extra or missing chromosome in every cell of their body. Trisomy XXY, for example, is an instance of a nondisjunction of the sex chromosomes that results in an extra X chromosome being inherited by a child. Now that we understand how nondisjunctions differ between mitosis and meiosis, let's try a practice problem to apply our knowledge. If a cell has a diploid number of 8 before meiosis, how many chromosomes will be in each of the four daughter cells if one pair of chromosomes experiences nondisjunction during meiosis 1? If you answered B, then you are correct. We know that the diploid number of chromosomes is 8, so that means if meiosis occurs normally, each of the gametes should have the haploid number of 4 chromosomes after division. However, in this scenario, we're told nondisjunction occurred in meiosis 1. If we remember, nondisjunctions in meiosis 1 are caused by the failure of homologous chromosome pairs to separate, resulting in abnormal chromosomal inheritance in all 4 daughter cells. Specifically, nondisjunctions in meiosis 1 result in 2 daughter cells with an additional chromosome and 2 with 1 missing chromosome. Since we know that the haploid number is 4, we can see that answer B is the correct choice in this scenario, as n plus 1 equals 5 and n minus 1 equals 3. If this nondisjunction had instead occurred during meiosis 2, characterized by the failure of sister chromatids to separate, we would expect only the gametes directly derived from the cell in which the nondisjunction occurred to be affected. This would leave us with answer C as the correct choice, as 2 cells would be unaffected and have 4 chromosomes, 1 cell would have an extra copy and thus have 5 chromosomes, and 1 cell would be missing a copy and would thus have 3 chromosomes. That concludes this video. Thanks for watching and have a great day.